You probably already know about the different versions of Windows, like Home Edition, Pro, even Enterprise. But there is another version of Windows for a very different kind of computer, which is called Windows Server. And while you may have heard of it, I ask you, how much do you really know about it? For me, the answer was basically nothing, so I decided to find out, not just by doing some research, but also by installing it myself and poking around for the most interesting stuff, which I'll show you. Turns out there are plenty of tools exclusive to Windows Server that we'll see, like a server manager, which is a major part, as well as, for example, an admin center to control almost every aspect of the server through a web interface. So I think you'll find this interesting, and by the end, you'll have a much better idea of how Windows Server is used. Of course, when it comes to your computer, there are things way more important than the version of Windows you have, like all those important pictures and critical documents that all of you have totally backed up, right? Right? Well, not to worry, it's not too late, which is where today's sponsor comes in, Crucial. You probably know Crucial as a long-standing leader in RAM and storage manufacturing. In fact, I did put their RAM in my new computer I just built before they even sponsored this video. So Crucial produces a wide selection of SSD storage drives, including their X6 and X8 external SSDs and P5 Plus, an internal NVMe SSD. And while today is actually World Backup Day, yes, that's a thing, these drives are good for much more than just backing up. The X6, for example, is really small, but with a big capacity, up to 4 terabytes, and speeds up to 800 megabytes per second. And the X8 is even faster, with up to 1,050 megabytes a second and up to 2 terabytes capacity, which makes both of these a great portable way to expand the storage on a laptop, for example, which many times have a fast but pretty small drive. And even if your computer does have lots of storage, then that's all the more reason to have this as a backup drive, so you can have the peace of mind that your data is both quickly accessible and safe. And since there are no moving parts, it's not even a big deal if you drop it, unlike a hard drive. Now, for super fast internal storage, you've got the Crucial P5 Plus, an NVMe SSD with the latest PCIe Gen 4 interface and speeds up to 6600 megabytes per second, which for gamers will be even more beneficial now that Windows Direct API storage is out, which will let game developers more fully utilize NVMe speeds when loading graphics for the GPU, significantly faster than a SATA connection. So whether you want to back up all your important documents and media, or just have more and faster storage, definitely check out Crucial's SSDs. You can check those links down in the description. And with all that being said, let's continue. All right, first things first, let's see what it's like for the installation process of Windows Server. So I'm using an ISO of the latest version, Windows Server 2022, and just putting it on a virtual machine. You can see there are actually two server editions possible here, the standard Windows Server and the Data Center Edition, which is the more expensive one. So let's go with that. The main difference from a regular Windows installation, though, is here you can actually choose to install either with a desktop experience or not, which is the graphical user interface. So that means you could run the server totally headless, it's called, and just use the command line to control it remotely. And interestingly, this is the one it specifically recommends. But that wouldn't be very interesting to show, so I'll choose the GUI. Beyond that, the installation process is the same, and eventually you boot up and have to create a user, and here's another difference, which is you can't choose a username, it has to be administrator. Once you boot into Windows, we can check out the more interesting stuff. So the first thing you'll notice is this server manager window pops up, which basically is how you configure everything on the server and install different services, which we'll go over. As for the interface, it's basically the same as the Windows 10 desktop, and also with the Windows 10 start menu, not the Windows 11 one. You can also see there's zero bloatware, obviously, and you can actually see how little there is in the start menu at all. Another unexpected difference is if you go to shut down the server, it actually asks you the reason and whether it was planned or not. I guess so it can be recorded in log files for reference, since presumably the server shouldn't be shutting down or restarting very often. Someone can go look back, see why that happened. Let's go back to that server manager though, because it's a really central part of what we'll be seeing. Now, to understand what we're looking at, let me give you some context. You see, a Windows server, or any server really, can have one or multiple dedicated purposes, which in Windows Server are called roles. So if you're at a big company, you might have one server that handles network routing stuff like DNS, another one that handles printing, and another one for file storage and backup or whatever else. So one of the first things you would have to do is install the associated services, they're called, for whatever particular roles you want for this server. And you can see there is an option to add roles and features where you do just that. there are many options, and from my understanding, in most cases, each server will be dedicated to only one or a couple roles, assuming there's the budget for that. But this video is not most cases. We want to see everything, so I'll just enable them all, which again is not something you'd want to do for both performance and security reasons. There's also another list of so-called features, which seem to be additional related tools, so of course I'll go and enable all those as well. Now, after we restart, things start to look a little bit more interesting. All those services we enabled now appear on the left-hand side of the server manager, though there isn't too much to see because none of it is configured. You can see that most of them require you to run a post-deployment configuration, which is fancy talk for you need to set them up. Now, I don't want to go through all that because I wouldn't even know how, but there are a couple we can look into right from the get-go, such as the fax service. We can see how there's menus for accounts, outgoing and incoming settings, and while they're empty, you can at least imagine how this would be used to manage how the server works. There's even a section for cover letter templates that are pre-installed, which I wasn't really expecting. Another example is file and storage services, which looks like it lets you manage storage across many devices and computers. For example, it lets you do stuff like scanning any drives, though I'm not sure how this would all look if there were actually other computers under management. So if you have a huge array of drives arranged in pools, you could manage that sort of thing here. One thing you might have noticed from before is in the start menu, there's a folder called Administrative Tools. You might wonder what that is. And these, for the most part, are the same ones you'd find in regular Windows in the control panel and also in the start menu. However, there are several tools that do not appear in regular Windows, and these seem to be mostly associated with some of the features I enabled from that list before. For example, there's Network Load Balancing Manager, though I don't think most of us would have any use for that. I did make a list though and compare the tools, and these are the ones I found that are only on the server, so you can look at that if you're interested. Again, though, many of these seem to only show up if you install a related service or feature. They're not installed with a fresh install of Windows Server. Anyway, moving on from that, though, the last cool thing I want to show you exclusive to Windows servers is what's called the Windows Admin Center. You actually have to download this from Microsoft and install it separately, but it allows you to remotely access and control the server via a web interface from any regular computer. And just looking through this, in my opinion, this is way more interesting than the server manager. I think this might be mostly what you'd use after it's all set up and you're just managing the server day to day. You can do stuff like seeing files and storage devices, configure the firewall, even edit the registry of the server. It also lets you see running processes and installed apps, almost like the task manager, as well as see roles and features we installed before. One cool menu is the performance monitor. It lets you add different trackers for performance, like amount of memory and CPU usage, and then have it graphed like this. Or you can have it displayed in other ways, like a table or text or bar charts, whatever. Now, after seeing all this, you might be wondering if Windows Server is something you would be able to or would want to install on an everyday computer. And the answer is technically you could, but you probably don't want to, even if just for the cost alone. The price of the standard edition is $1,069, which I refuse to believe was not chosen as a meme. And the Data Center edition costs a whopping $6,155. But there's also an Essentials for $501. Okay, seriously, who's coming up with these prices? Anyway, despite these premium prices, as a desktop user, you would get absolutely no benefit. It's not like anything would run any faster. It still uses the same kernel or core of Windows as all the other editions. In fact, some of your devices may not work at all, since those are consumer devices and may not be validated and tested on Windows Server editions, and therefore the drivers may refuse to install on that. Plus, the server version doesn't have many consumer-focused services pre-installed, so things might not work as expected. For example, it's missing the Network Connected Devices Auto Setup services, Parental Controls, the Windows Backup Service, Wireless LAN AutoConfig, BitLocker, and more. So don't think you're missing out. But still, now you know more about it if you ever were wondering, and if you are someone who might be able to use Windows Server in the future for one of its true purposes, this might be helpful, at least as a starting point. Thanks again to Crucial for sponsoring this video. Be sure to check out their SSD drives, including the X6, X8, and P5 Plus, and check the link for those in the description. So let me know what you think down in the comments. If you have any corrections, definitely let me know. I know I'm not an expert here. And if you enjoyed this video, maybe check out some of the other videos on my channel, and consider subscribing. And also be sure to click the bell next to the subscribe button if you do to get notifications. I only make videos about twice a week. You don't want those getting lost in the rest of your subscriptions. If you want to keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is one where I was talking about super hidden files in Windows, I call them. It's something not many people know about, so I think you'll find that interesting. I'll put that link right there. So thanks so much for watching, everyone, and I'll see you in the next one.